Right, time for some The Maze of Gallius. I already made an introduction of the game in the pilot, but this is a proper episode one. The pilot was a test. So, The Maze of Gallius, I think it's from 1983, might not be. You're not here for expertise about the history of video games, just a casual playthrough. And we're gonna play Popolin and Aphrodite, exploring a little dungeon. So you've got two characters. This is the first one, Popolin. He is stronger than Aphrodite to break rocks and kill creatures. And when you kill creatures, you rise your XP bar, and when you rise your XP bar to the maximum, you gain a level which only affects your health bar. Aphrodite, in the meantime, she's weaker when she hits stuff, but she can breathe underwater much longer. So the bats are easy to kill because they just take a single hit. They just move around a lot. So if I want to break that stone, takes like 15 hits. If I was using Popolin, it would be much faster. Now I'm gonna take that key. That's a key to a world, because we're gonna explore this big dungeon, and scattered around the dungeon you got doors to other worlds which you can explore, but you need the key and you need to go through them in order. So I took Aphrodite when I'm picking that key, because it's gonna level her up a lot and raise her health bar, which will be very useful. Yay! So now my key is in the inventory for later. So all good. Let's switch back to Popolin. I'm going to show you that to compare breaking stones. Yeah, it's like 5 or 3. Little skeletons, my favorite to level up, because they're quite weak. You can hit them only from the back, but once you hit them, they're harmless. So let's continue here. We're gonna find something down there. So that's a game I used to play as a kid, like in 87, maybe 88. And over here we've got, so you see resources on the top right. In red, it's the arrows. I don't have any in store yet. And the resource arrows can be pretty much anything which you find. You can find different weapons, but they are the same resource you will consume. It can be landmines, different types of arrows, like the regular red arrow. So it's an arrow which is shown, but actually what I'm picking up, it's more like a bow. So I need to equip it. There you go. Now, if once I have arrows in my inventory, I'll be able to shoot them. Right under the sort of yellowish thing, it's actually a coin. So I got one losey coin right now. You get coins by killing creatures or there. Behind the rocks, you can find coins stashes, which are like 5 or 10 coins at a time. And then you got the keys, which you need to open this sort of pinkish, reddish thing there. I don't have any key right now. Oh, those were some arrows. So I'm gonna show you later what the arrows look like. But right now, I'm just doing a minimum of exploration in the easy corners at the beginning of the dungeon to level up, because my health bar is really small right now, so needs some tender loving care to be risen. So yeah, I was like between 6 or 8 when my father brought an MSX, which was the gaming platform, sort of a microcomputer with integrated keyboard. It used cartridges. and it had this massive collection of awesome Konami games. If you're not aware, the very first Metal Gear, which was called Metal Gear, not Metal Gear Solid, the Hideo Kojima game, was a 8-bit game like this one. It was just called Metal Gear, and it was on the MSX, so or something. I think mine was. It was not even. I don't think it was even like the property MSX of a single company. You had different companies building and distributing them. I think mine was made by Philips. I still got it. It's at my mom. The best way to get rid of bats is to wait for them to be hanging. And this behind this rock, you've got a little aureola. So now it's in my inventory. So this whole screen is going to be full of stuff by the end of the game, if I manage to finish the game, because I never managed to as a kid. It's rather complicated, especially without the resources which the internet offer. But yeah, for instance, the aureola, which I found out, I don't even remember how as a kid, maybe hitting stuff randomly. When you are in the item menu and you hit enter, it's going to take you to the place where you can save. And saving is based on the Konami code, so I will explain about that towards the end. So that's actually the door to World 1, because I got a key, I just opened the door. So I'm not equipped with what I need to succeed at level 1. First of all, I need a magnifier glass in order to read tombstones, to find a word which will invoke the final boss. So when you reach the room of the final boss, you need to type the name of the boss on the keyboard. Of course, if you don't have the internet, you need to find it in-game by investigating tombstone with your magnifier glass. Here's an item just for this world. There it is. And it gives me that map on the bottom left. So you see this dungeon world slash world is shaped like a key. I'm just gonna make a bit of XP here because it's easy. Those stuff just jump as you do, so except in a few places they're not very dangerous. It's more like a puzzle game to solve them. Cheers. I'm not going down that hole yet. But the skeletons are back. And skeletons are good for experience. So yeah, be nice if tonight I manage to bring my little Popolin at the same level of Aphrodite. My keyboard is in AZERTY, so I need to push the other button for the arrow. What's good with the arrows is that I'm wasting them right now. Ah, come on. They do the same damage whether you are Aphrodite or... Oh, I leveled up. Now I got an almost insignificant improvement to my health bar. Come on. Nothing. Okay, thank you very much. I think I'm gonna try to go get some boots, which would improve the speed of my characters. Oh, I thought I could shoot from the... So I'm using the ROM for this game? Ah, I'm out of arrows. Yeah, I'm using the ROM of this game, so it's accurate to the original game. But you can find a remake, which looks better, even remakes music. You can decide whether, even with the remake, you can decide whether to play in the original version or the remake. But yeah, it's quite cool and easy to install and find on the internet. So if you're not keen on finding ROMs and so on, which I found it thanks to my brother. He sent it to me because I'm completely clueless about this sort of stuff. Yeah, I know a good corner to earn XP in the worst, most grindy. Oh. Grindy way. Oh no, but I shouldn't go there yet. Because I need money before I go there. Because I need money for a new shield. And for the magnifying glass. And if I'd, otherwise it's useless. Yeah, there should be some money up there. Aye. Yeah, my health is already looking very bad. I'm gonna be a coward and go back down to the weak corners. Oh yeah, 50 arrows, things are much better, so that's it. Yeah, I'm gonna kill some stupid worms before I do anything else, because otherwise Poppin's gonna die. And when you die, when one of your character dies, that's it, pretty much. There's a place where you can go to resurrect one of your characters. If your two characters die, that's it. You start from the beginning or from your last save. But yeah, I think there's a place where you can resurrect your little companion for 100 coins. But A, I don't have 100 coins. B, I don't remember where it was, so we'll find out playing this, not tonight, but over time. And second, I believe it's a pain in the A to get to, and I certainly don't have the health, even with Aphrodite, to reach that place. Is there anyone in the chat room watching, or just bots? Probably just a bunch of bots. That's good, they keep me company. Just love the music. That's the soundtrack of my childhood. Probably play other MSX games like Penguin Adventure, maybe Nightmare, because Nightmare 2 is actually a sequel. Although the very first Nightmare was a vertical shooter, it was not at all a dungeon exploration game like this one. 22, 23. Okay, let's try this way. That consumed a key. Come on, give me some arrows. Give me some coins. Yeah. Okay, I got arrows. I'm gonna go to the place when I can do and get experience, because I think I can also get money there. So I'm sorry for this grinding which is about to take place. Something was almost there. Yeah, that's so bad. My health is so low. So the bell rings when you approach the door of a world. I think the one you got the key for, so it might not ring. Need the boots. I got the boots. No. Start over. How do I start over again? Don't remember. I'm gonna reboot the ROM. Wow, Populin died super fast in the water. Yep, old school. No, I wanted that for Aphrodite. Did we have? Yeah, the first levels are quite hard. I mean, it's not like crazy hard, but it's a grind, a bit of a grind. Once we got a nice little save to start from with a good health bar, we'll be less about surviving, a bit more about going super far to fetch an object and make the right decision to spawn back to the saving point. There's gold here, I should remember that, because stuff you find behind rocks, they spawn back after a while, once you've been far enough from from them. Should check maybe on how many screens you're supposed away you're supposed to be. So you can have kind of your routine of going around specific places to refill your keys, your arrows, your gold. Okay, two keys. It's not great, but that's alright. Oh, I forgot to equip my little arrow. No. Make a tiny bit of research, and there's actually very long articles on TV tropes about these games. This game apparently was the first to introduce a lot of elements, including the idea of having this couple as the heroes and the skeletons also. Oh. Should read about that and tell about it next time, I guess. If you go on YouTube and SoundCloud, you'll find a lot of people who made remixes of the soundtrack. I just absolutely love it. Come on. What am I doing? Come on. I did bad for the pilot. Should have used that save. I'm gonna go in another corner to show you around a bit tonight. And grab the arrow, the skeleton arrow, which is really good for killing skeletons. But first the red arrow. Okay, what if I tried to get as many objects as possible? Yeah, my brother considered speedrunning this game, and then he thought it was a bit too, not hard, but too much all over the place to speedrun. So the bat returns, much easier to kill this way. Come on, okay, I'm gonna go get that skeleton. Gold. Yeah, I did get the Aureola. So I'm going there manually, but thanks to the Aureola, I could jump straight to where I'm trying to go. Team here, and there's an object there on the left behind that rock, if I remember correctly. So at some point I can get an item which makes me oh no, I thought there was something here, invulnerable to, well, make it so that the steam doesn't affect me. Shadows. No, I don't think the bats reappear. They do. So that little door here is where you save your game. Seems I'm here, might as well. Thankfully the Konami code is in Romaji characters, despite the game being in Japanese. Well, I'm gonna do a little screenshot to save that. Actually, I could try the save function in the ROM. I'm gonna do both. Oh, that save function. Save state. Okay. State save to slot 0. So what I want, the arrow is on the left, but let me take a peek to the right. Okay, so that's where we are. Mm-hmm. Oh, come on, seriously? Ow, okay, I got it. No! Screenshotting again. Okay, so I need some easy experience for Popolin. I think that might happen here. It's really one hit and I'm dead. Oh, but wait. The skeleton keys now. Yeah, one hit. Oops. So they're just slower actually. And because they're slower, they hit like 2 times the target instead of 1. First. Okay, again, doing the coward thing. Ayo. Work. I'm not sure exactly how, but it's fine. Okay. Let's see if I can kill a few more things before I go. I won't be playing. Those guys are really annoying to kill. No. Yay. Okay, what's up there? Should hit them twice. Seriously? Come on. No. So I think that's ouch. Come on, Aphrodite, you can do it. Seriously, no bonus. Oh, do I need to kill those two guys to get it? I don't remember what's supposed to be here, but it feels like something should be around here. To another world. Boring. Okay. So that's why I made a save, and that's it for tonight. That was the Maze of Gallius. If you thought that was remotely interesting, please consider following us on Twitch, maybe subscribing on YouTube, where you upload those sessions. And you can also subscribe to my show. We've got episodes up there in audio on iTunes, Apple Podcasts, and Spotify, the Rollist podcast. You will find all of this very good content about tabletop role-playing game instead of video game role-playing games. On that was Kalum. Thank you very much for watching this. See you whenever. See you soon. Take care. Stay safe. Cheers.